It's a panic attack, that's all.
What?
It sounds like you're having a panic attack.
I can't breathe. I can't.
Maybe it's because you want to fuck your sister.
What?
Do you want to fuck your sister?
No. Jesus.
It's just people say panic attacks come from some deeply repressed sexual urges, you know?
What?
I was just testing a theory, see? Actually, you're talking shit, because it turns out a panic attack's just a fuckload of adrenaline mainlining into your heart. It's just how we deal with danger. Fight or flight, they call it. Right?
I don't know you.
You're a fighter or a flighter, Tony Stonem? It's depending on your answer. Well, a lot depends on your answer. See you around. Hi, Effie.
How are you?
I'm fine.
How are you?
Good. It's Tony here. We need to speak to him. Tea, coffee, anyone?
No, thanks.
No, I'm fine.
Tony?
No, thank you.
You okay, Tony? You seem a little under... well, under the bed.
I'm fine.
Tony, come out.
I prefer not to.
Listen, I think we need to talk about this.
I really don't know what you mean.
Well, me and Sid are together now.
Yeah, I know.
And you're obviously not okay with it.
Who says I'm not?
Well, you did pretty much last night.
Oh, come on. It's like taking the piss. You know, because it's funny.
Listen, do you mind? I've got an interview. Got to get ready.
All right. Oh, okay. See you later, Tony.
Bye, Tony.
Take this. That's stuff. Maps and shit.
Okay.
You look really good, Tony. Like you're ready for anything.
Thanks. Sit down.
Hi,
a bloke. He wakes up one morning. He gets dressed, he goes down the stairs, he makes himself a little bit of breakfast. He walks to the garage, he gets in his car, starts his car, drives off, I don't know, a couple of miles. Stops, gets out of his car. Has a couple of blokes pour petrol over his head and sets fire to himself.
He what?
He sets fire to himself. Fucking boom! What's in the bay?
My sandwiches.
So what we got?
Ham and cheese, chicken or egg and cress.
Egg and cress? Isn't life wonderful? You looking?
I don't... what?
A few scars. A few marks. What do you think of them?
I think they're horrible.
Yeah, at least I've got to make this. I fucking wear them, right?
Right.
How about you? Do you have any marks?
No, I'm fine.
Oh, yeah, of course you are. You're fine and dandy.
Old, the age of opportunity. I bet you can't wait to come here. Imagine it, being able to live away from your parents and you can do anything you like stay up all night and eat ice cream. Derek.
Thanks, Polly. So, new home, new friends, new horizons, the good times, the bad times.
The parties, oh my God, the parties.
The loves that will never be, even though they seem so right.
Just remember, though, that if you will drink, and personally, I have a bitter lemon. But if you do, just don't overdo it, or you won't be able to get up in the morning for your lectures.
So, any more questions before group sessions?
Are you two shagging or what?
No, we're not. I adore Derek to bits, but he's more like a brother. But you'll make friends like that here too. Friends who appreciate that you never, never, never want that to happen. So, no, we're certainly not doing that.
No, we're not. We're truly not.